Hello everyone, and welcome back to Art History Shorts and to our month of talking about creepy and scary paintings in celebration of Halloween. When I was thinking about what artworks I wanted to talk about for this month, this one came pretty quickly to mind, and that is The Nightmare by Henry Fuseli. So every time I see this painting, I'm always surprised that it was done in 1781. And actually at the time it was exhibited a year later in 1782, it was considered a very innovative piece and even a little shocking at the time. Got a lot of attention because of the subject matter. The other works that the art was exhibited with, those subjects were drawn more from history, from the Bible, and from literature, more of the neoclassical style that was popular around this time. But this was a product of Fuseli's own mind, and it shows the shift that was happening where artists were moving away, more away from the virtuous style of neoclassicism to the more emotional romanticism period. The subject matter of this painting has erotic undertones, something that many of his paintings following also had, and actually after he died, his wife destroyed many of those pieces, especially the ones where she was a model in them. This painting, so it isn't explicit, but it's rather more suggestive. It leaves the viewer to make its own assumptions about the meaning, and there are different interpretations of the nightmare as Fuseli was vague about them. He was interested in psychology and continued to create art that explored the imagination, a person's subconscious, and what happens below the surface of our minds. So in this painting, we see three figures. There's a horse pushing through the red draped curtains of the background, a woman in white lying on a bed, asleep or in an unconscious state, and then on top of her, sitting on top of her, is a demon known as an incubus. This is a mythological creature said to prey upon women, often sexually, as they sleep and cause feelings of suffocation associated with sleep paralysis and nightmares. The symbolism of this painting and the figures might actually represent something a little more personal to Fuseli. The discovery of an unfinished portrait of a woman on the back has led some historians to believe that the scene of this woman and the incubus represents an unrequited love of Fuseli's. His use of the dramatic chiaroscuro really heightens the unsettling feelings the painting evokes, casting the creature in shadow and veiling its intentions in the dark. The way it looks out onto the viewer is also pretty disturbing, like it's including you in its dark intentions. This painting brings up these concerns and these feelings of feeling unsafe while you're sleeping, much like our subconscious, where we don't always know what's going on beneath the surface. We don't always know or can't always know what's going on around us. We could be as vulnerable as this woman sleeping, not knowing about the danger that's sitting right on top of her, suffocating her as she sleeps. This painting really cemented Fuseli's career as an artist. He gained popularity and commercial success and even sold engravings of this painting at an affordable price so he could reach a wider audience. It's also said that Sigmund Freud had a print of this painting. So Fuseli was a teacher at the Royal Academy. He was influential to other artists like Turner, John Constable, and William Blake. And he was also influential to the Surrealist movement because of his work painting from his imagination and also the exploration of his dreams. So if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more about art and artists from me, please subscribe to the channel. Next time I'll be wrapping up our Halloween paintings. So I really hope you enjoyed this month, and thank you so much everyone for watching.